Okay, as I said in the previous video, I'm going to focus this on making it a little bit more, well, not a bit more. I'm going to focus on making this for a WebGL platform. Okay, but that doesn't mean we have to disable or delete the code we've written. We're going to do a few changes that are going to be more platform specific. More precise, the thing is with WebGL, we can technically save into somebody's PC. Okay, so, well, actually, I don't know why I click that. So that means we need to do something with our level editor. Okay, and obviously there is a lot of ways to do this. There is ways you can actually save WebGL. Okay, with the flexibility that we have with our level editor, we could just do a lot of things, even just save the entire level and you know, use that and upload it somewhere, maybe Amgur, and the users can download it and over there. Okay, we're not going to worry about any of that. We're just going to save them right there on the editor. They're not really huge. Okay, like if we go, even if I open the Explorer, you will see that it's 5 kilobytes, so it's not really that much of you know, a memory thing. So just keeping them on the memory is going to be okay. And if you think about it, well, at least for these examples, probably most people will just play for a short amount of time. So, you know, nobody cares. Awesome. So, let's go. We're not going to need this scene anymore. So, remove it. No need to worry about it. And let's go into our scripts. And more specifically, into our level editor. Okay. So, the first thing we need to do is check if we have, if this is actually, what platform it is. We're going to add, let's add a public bool is WebGL, and on awake, we can just use if application dot platform WebGL, well, is WebGL will be true. Okay, awesome. So if WebGL is true, we should go on to, let's see, let's go directly to the level editor, and we're going to make a list of our save files. Okay, let's do that. So list save file or level file say level files. Let's initialize as well, and let's create also a dictionary with string and integer, which is the key, which is the entry they have inside this list, the level file. And over here, let's call this level dictionary. Oops. Awesome. So we need a way to distinguish between level files. So we're going to name this public string level name. Now, when you are loading all your levels, as you see in here, we're going to do a branch and say if is WebGL, okay, return. And instead of doing this, we're just simply going to go and say for every object you have in your level files, then a variable levels.add level files level name. To be a little bit more consistent, onto our save over here, we can also say server.level name, the level name we have above. Okay, so this will also save a level. But here's where we're going to do another branch, because this is going to try and write into the disk. Okay, obviously we don't want any of that. We're just simply going to say if is WebGL, do a return, and instead of saving it to the list, we're going to say level files dot add save. And we should also add level dictionary dot add level add save dot level name, and this will be, actually we're going to have an issue with this. Okay, so let's rework this a little bit. We're going to say level file is duplicate. Okay, we're going to be passing the level file itself, yes, and we're going to be going through all our level objects dot count, and if string dot is equals level objects dot level name. Not level objects, level files dot level name with the s dot level name, then we want to return the level file so we know what to delete from our list. Return null. Okay, we're still going to go with, if they have the same name, they're going to just be replaced. So let's see, where is the save? Well, save the file is this over here, is duplicate. Let's save the level file, level file d is duplicate, save, and if d is not null, then we want to remove level files, remove the duplicate, and let's see, though we still need to get the index on our dictionary. So say this string to int dictionary, and yeah, let's do dictionary string, oops, string integer dictionary, and then we have string key. Okay, and this will just do index, let's start from -1, did try get value key out index, and then return the index. Over here we're going to start with a target index, which is just going to be level files dot count -1. Okay, Actually, no, not minus one. Count, that's going to be one. Yeah, target index. Target index. And let's see. Then target index string to integer level dictionary, and the key is going to be s dot or save dot level name. Okay, then level dictionary dot add save dot level name, and the key is going to be your target index. So what just happened? We find first the index we want, or the index we're going to take it like there's no duplicate, so it's going to be added last on the level files or the level list we have. Then we're going to check if it's a duplicate or not. This compares with the level names. Because we compare with strings, it's going to be a little bit slower than normal, but yeah, we're not really counting on having large amounts of data over here, so nobody cares. Okay, so if it's a duplicate, basically, so the level file returns something, we're going to remove the duplicate file from our level files list, and then we're going to find the target index. The target index is not going to be just added right on the list. It's going to be replacing. Actually, this need to change. Yeah. So instead of doing a remove, we should probably be doing. Level files target index. So let's reverse the order over here. Target index save. Okay, instead of deleting the level, we're going to be simply replacing the entries. And if it's not a duplicate, then we just add it into the list. And then, of course, we add the dictionary. Okay. Simple. Nothing really complicated. So, if it's a WebGL, we're simply not storing it inside our stream. Okay. We just keep it locally. Then we have the saved file. We also need to do load. Let's see what else we should do. Is duplicate, save location, yeah, we don't care. Load level, load our levels, let's see. This is working. Okay, this is working as well. Let's see then our load. So when we are creating a level over here, we of course need to load the level. That happens in here. And you can see that this will try and load it from file. Obviously, that's not what we want to do anymore, or in WebGL. So we're simply going to say if game manager is WebGL, do a return. But before you do a return, simply say find the index of the level name index string to integer level name. And then, Oh, we need to also pass the dictionary, and that will be level dictionary, level name, and then our save file is going to be level files index, and actually return the save file. Okay, much more straightforward, much more simpler. Now, to avoid any problems, we should probably okay, let's test this first. And to test that, of course, I'm not in a WebGL format, and we're not going to be doing a build every time. So I'm just going to comment this line out, and every time it runs, we start the game, it's going to consider it like it's a WebGL. Let's see what errors we have. Okay. Oh, come on. Oh. Okay. Hit play. Of course, you will see there's no, we don't load anymore the level down here, so we need to just do create a new one or something, spawn exit point. Okay, let's yeah, this will change as well, so let's change that. We already had an event, let's see. Our UI element. Okay, let's go check on this. We have the paint, handle mouse input, and paint spawn exit. If GM over UI element return. Okay, save that. Hit play. Go to the editor, let's paint something. Spawn, exit point. Save, back, play, okay, back, editor. Let's call this test 2, and as you can see, we have a small issue down here. We actually paint, even if we are on top. Actually, yeah, for some reason, we actually paint over here, which makes no sense. Anyway, test 2, back, test 2 place. In every way it can, and editor again. Okay, this was the test 2. Let's keep the same name, but let's make something else for a level. Save, back, test 2, play. Okay, so it's working nicely. Awesome. And let's see. Yeah, I think that will do for WebGL, to be honest. No need to complicate things more. We just won't have any starting levels. But this could actually be overridden. So for example, if we do level file, let's see, I don't think it's going to work if we Yeah, it's not going to work because we have a byte array and we have the sellable vectors as well. Okay, we can just do this. Texture 2D level texture. Not level texture. PNG level. And on the save file, where we are doing that, if it's a WebGL, or yeah, this can actually work both ways, doesn't matter. And say return save file. See what we're calling that. Save load demands, save level texture. But first, we're going to say if save dot PNG level equals null, do this, else level texture dot not dot equals save dot PNG level. With that said, we can just go on the level editor. Let's just assign a default or somewhere, it doesn't really matter. We can just do public texture 2D default level, and then on init we can make a level file. I don't want to make this public because they are serialized fields, so it's going to mess things up. We don't want that. So level file default level, new level file default level dot level name, not level texture, level name, assign it as default, doesn't matter, and then default level dot PNG level, PNG level is going to be your default level, and no, it's a texture 2D. Oh, yeah, we have okay, it's going to be your default level. Let's see. And we need spawn positions as well. Default level dot spawn position, new savable vector. And this will be t level dot spawn position dot x. Let's go. Let's see what this is. 1.9. I think it's going to be 158 by 170. I'm not entirely sure. Let's see. Let's say 150 on the x. D level spawn position dot y 150. We might need to change this. I'm not sure. X position, new savable vector. Let's see what the exit position has. 781. And on the height, 18 pixels probably. So the level exit position dot x 781. The level dot exit position dot y 18. Okay, then take this default level and add it into our level files. Add the level. Hopefully we didn't forget something. And I think we didn't. Okay. And you know what? We actually don't need this. We can just, yeah, ignore this, game manager, ignore this as well. And just do on top over here, just do the byte array default level dot encode to png. So it's going to do the same thing with less code. Okay, let's go then to the game manager, and I'm just going to assign the level we see over here. Let's see where it is. I think it's level 1. Let's test. Oops. Let's test it then. Okay, default level. Hit play. Let's see. What do we Yeah, the spawn position and X positions are just wrong, so you know. Let's see where they are instantiated or where they are. Oh, 150 and 170, which is probably, yeah, it's out of bounds. So that will be, on the level editor, that will be, this, probably. Okay, so this works and we have a default level to play with. Awesome. Cool. And you can see the minimap over here. It's really came along nice, as you can see. Really cool. And we have any changes we have on the morphology, we can still do them. We should of course probably add and limit the abilities over here, but I think this, because this is just an example, we should just ignore it, because yeah, it's just an example. Or maybe we can do this, we will see. So anyway, about the platform specific stuff, we are actually clear, and I think I just want to end the video here, so we are consistent with one theme per lesson. Okay, so yeah, let's end this one here. So it's complete. You know what to do: like, subscribe, and of course, if you like to see more, if you like this to support me so I can keep making more, then of course consider supporting me either on Patreon or via Gumroad, so that I can keep making all these nice little stuffs. So I'll see you next time.